After completion of their 4.5 years of MBBS course, all FMCIs will have to join Indian Armed Forces as a commissioned medical officer. On the basis of merit cum choice, 50% of the medical cadets are offered permanent commission and the rest are offered short service commission. AFMC is the only medical college in India after which the cadets can be directly granted permanent commission. But if a person joins Indian Armed Forces after completing MBBS from any other medical college, then at first he or she will be granted short service commission. Selection of short service commissioned officers for grant of permanent commission is decided by a selection board with interviews in the office of DG AFMS. Short service commission is for 7 years, extendable up to maximum 14 years. Permanent commission is up to the age of retirement. Any cadet who doesn't want to join Indian Armed Forces after completion of his or her 4.5 years of MBBS course, then he or she is free to do so after paying the bond money signed at the time of admission in AFMC. The bond money for year 2019 was Rs. 30 lakhs. No bond money will be recovered from the medical cadets who are declared unfit for commissioning or NSL on following medical grounds: due to disease or circumstances beyond his or her control, due to disease or circumstances which are attributable to the training curriculum of MBBS, due to disease or circumstances necessitating withdrawal from the college, or due to death. However, the NSL medical cadets may be permitted to continue their medical education on approval of DG AFMS and payment of cost of training as approved by the government from the day they are declared NSL due to medical grounds. AFMC provides highest paid internship among all medical colleges in India. All commissioned medical officers have a good starting pay of approximately ₹85,000 per month with subsidized accommodation. During internship, the medical officers are granted lieutenant or equivalent rank. Interns learn a lot and have no pressure for solving MCQs for PG entrance exam. Affiliated hospitals for internship are Command Hospital Southern Command Pune, Military Hospital Kirki Pune, Military Hospital Jodhpur, Base Hospital Delhi Kent, Military Hospital Ambala, Military Hospital Jalandhar, 167 Military Hospital Pathankot, 166 Military Hospital Jammu, Command Hospital Northern Command Udhampur, 92 Base Hospital Srinagar, Command Hospital Western Command Chandi Mandir, Military Hospital Dehradun, Command Hospital Central Command Lucknow, Military Hospital Meerut, 151 Base Hospital Guwahati, Command Hospital Eastern Command Kolkata, Military Hospital Namkum, Military Hospital Secunderabad. For those commissioned in Air Force, there are two hospitals. The first one is 7 Air Force Hospital Kanpur and the second one is Command Hospital Air Force Bangalore. And for those commissioned in Navy, there are two naval hospitals. The first one is INHS Aswini Mumbai and the second one is INHS Kalyani Vizag. Here is the table depicting ranks and its corresponding monthly basic pay of all commissioned medical officers. In addition to monthly basic pay, military service pay, that is MSP, non-practicing allowance and DRN's allowance as applicable will also be provided. One should note that the final salary in hand is equal to basic pay plus MSP plus non-practicing allowance plus DRN's allowance. Officers get 3 years to enjoy life after MBBS, serving as a medical officer, and also plan as to which subject to specialize in, rather than continuously studying. Unlike civil government medical colleges in India, where there are less than 10,000 seats for more than 50,000 medical graduates, the seats for post-graduation in armed forces is almost double the number of medical graduates passed each year through AFMC. More than 300 MD-MS-DNB seats are available per year in various facilities for 145 AFMC graduates and direct entry short service commissioned officers. Unlike any other medical college, medical officers are full paid during their entire PG course. Every year, 50 to 70 medical officers are selected on merit for super specialization and are given up to 3 years full pay leave to train in premier institutions in India and abroad. Ex-short service commissioned officers are given opportunity to join PG courses or super specialty courses in service institutions for up to 3 years without additional bond liability. So they can practice in any private or government institute after completion of their course. There is ample scope for travel and adventure while serving as a medical officer with pride and dignity. Also, a safe and respected career for women. The armed forces provide group insurance of Rs 50 lakhs to all medical officers. All medical officers are provided up to 60 days annual leave and 20 days casual leave in a year. All commissioned officers and their dependents are provided with an annual railway warrant for 2nd AC railway coach. Also, instead of this railway warrant, they can also travel via flight and can claim their LTC. All medical officers are provided with free accommodation facility in highly secured campus area of Indian Armed Forces. The accommodation facilities are based upon their ranks. All commissioned officers are provided with 2 CSD cards, 1 grocery card and 1 liquor card. These CSD cards are valid across all CSD canteens in India. All commissioned officers are provided with free medical facilities for self and family, including parents. All defense personnel on retirement are eligible for pension, which is 50% of the average emoluments drawn during the last 10 months. The minimum qualifying service to earn pension is 20 years in case of commissioned officer. So the pension is not valid for short service commissioned officer.